Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how to integrate ESP8266 running the firmware Tasmota with Google Smart Home to work with Google Assistant and also Google Home app. The prerequisite is that you should have a Google Smart Home application running in Google Cloud with your credentials. Check my first video on this channel to see how to do it. This is the summary of this video. The first step is to have an ESP8266 flashed with Tasmota firmware. Then, we create and configure a new device for Google Smart Home. And finally, I will demonstrate this device working with Google Home and also Google Assistant. So, let's get started. Tasmota is an open source firmware for ESP8266 device. So you can flash any ESP8266 device with Tasmota, and this firmware provides you many functionalities to easily connect your device with sensors, and you can also control your ESP using MQTT protocol. There are many more functionalities behind this firmware. You can check the official page for more details. To start using the firmware Tasmota, you need firstly to flash it in your ESP8266 device. The process is very similar to uploading a code from Arduino IDE, but it cannot be done on Arduino IDE. You need another tool for it. There are some tools available to flash the ESPs with Tasmota. I will use the tool Tasmotizer in a Linux machine. So, follow the instructions to install this tool. Connect your ESP8266 device with your computer using USB or FTDI adapter and flash it with the latest Tasmota.bin file. After flashing the ESP device, it will boot and enter in access point mode for the first time. Then you need to connect to this access point by browsing the default IP, or the browser in your mobile or computer will redirect automatically to this default IP. On this default IP, Tasmota provides a web user interface to control and configure the ESP. Then provide your Wi-Fi credentials and save. The Wi-Fi credentials will be stored in the EEPROM memory of the ESP device, so you don't need to enter it again as long as you do not clean up the configuration. Power cycle again the device, and now it will be connected to your Wi-Fi network after startup. You can check via your Wi-Fi router or using another tool the IP assigned to this device. It's not an access point anymore. It's like a web server. So you can also check it on Tasmotizer with device connect to USB or FTDI. Then open a browser and access this IP. In this web interface, you can configure the MQTT credentials and also add sensors in the GPIOs of your device. For instance, on template generic, I'm adding a relay, an output, in GPIO 0, and a button input on GPIO 02, as I'm using ESP1. Okay, now your ESP8266 is ready to be used, and now let's test it for the first time. As you can see, by acting on the toggle button on the Tasmota web interface, we can change the GPIO state. We can also change the GPIO 0 state by acting on the button that is connected to GPIO 2. Now let's check it using MQTT. I have MQTT client Mosquito installed in my computer. So I'm publishing a message toggle on this topic that belongs to Tasmota device. Both are using the same MQTT broker on my host octopi.local. Now let's make this Tasmota device to talk to Google Home and Google Assistant. We need first to create a new device for Google Home. To create a new device, the process is the same as I showed in my second video, using a front-end application provided by Google Samples for Google Home. When we create a new device, a random device ID is created. Then we need to change the configuration of Tasmota to use this new ID on its MQTT topic, as I'm showing here. The Java backend code needs also to be modified to use the new topic format defined by Tasmota firmware. Just remember to use the same MQTT broker in your Java application and your Tasmota device. Now, let's test it all together with Google Home and Google Assistant. So here is my mobile, so I will open Google Home. And then my new device is here, smart switch. So I will start clicking on the on switch. Yes, as you can see here, the LED on GPIO 0 was turned on. Also here on Tasmota web interface is showing on. And the MQTT stat was set to 1. So let's turn it off. Yes, as you can see, the LED was turning off. So now let's check with Google Assistant. Turn on smart switch. Okay, so now let's turn it off. Turn off my smart. Okay, I hope you have enjoyed this video. This is my first start with Tasmota and Google Assistant and Google Home. I hope you have enjoyed. On next videos, I will explore a bit more the Tasmota devices. Thanks for watching!